A minute 54 seconds. Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda Blind. A couple things. Just for kicks, I figured I'd time how long it takes for me to get in the game from clicking the icon on my desktop, and that's a minute and 54 seconds. It took 44 seconds just for the actual game screen to come up, you know, with the logos and everything like that. See the beginning of episode 1. And 58 seconds total to get to a main menu where I can go load. And then almost a full minute after that to get the game actually loaded. And here we are. A minute and 54 seconds. Longest loading ever, personally speaking. And I have this. This game is loaded on a, I can't remember the name. But I have one right here. I can't remember the name of anything lately. I have this loaded on a SSD drive, so we're not waiting for, you know, hard drive platters to rotate around and stuff like that. So it's loaded on a SSD drive, and yes, I have a very good rig if you want to see what it is, what my rig specs are. I mean, it's nowhere near to top of the line, but it should be able to handle this right, and I've talked to people who have even better setups than this, and they're reporting the same thing. When the game first loads, you get all choppy like this, and then we're fine. It's like the game has trouble loading the textures or something like that. And sometimes when you go into a new area as well. But I notice it the most upon loading a saved game. So that's that. And it stutters on high. It stutters on ultra. I'm not sure if it stutters any worse on ultra. Maybe I should put it back to ultra. And see how it goes. Anyway. Enough blabbing about. Yeah, so if you want to see my computer specs, if you're curious, you can go to my About page, and it's all listed there. Now, I don't think we can get anywhere from here. Just looking around. Oh, pretty much not.
Ryder, when you've got a minute, stop by the medbay.
Yeah, she already told me that. So we can go this way to go to medbay? I forget. Or do I have to go down some ladders? We're headed away. Vetra, Liam, Lexi. Lexi wants us. So we need to go to deck 3. Oh, deck 1 is the bridge. Oh, just the meeting room? Oh, wait. Pathfinder. The galaxy map shows up on all levels. That's weird. Med bay, so... Yeah, okay. So, we gotta go down to deck 3. Yeah, cargo bay, storage. Engineering. Bridges. Deck 2. Right, so we need to go down 1, obviously. But we need to be going this way. So I'm going to take one of those ladders. Right, there's ladders over here. Or they're here. Alright. Does anyone go down a ladder like this in real life? It probably hurt your hands. Well, they're probably really smooth, like well-constructed and stuff. Oh. There's a separate did I look in here? I might have. I did, yes, and I lamented about the fact that we couldn't actually, you know, flush the toilet and go in the shower. So now we're on deck 3, but we're headed in the wrong direction. But we're close. We're close by. Crew quarters. Med bay. Here we go. See what the good doctor wants.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years in the Hyperion looking after your brother.
Yet this makes no sense because we already came here and saw her and she said a couple lines to us. Well... Oh, welcome aboard.
Happy to have you, Dr. DePero.
I'll do my best. Now, hold still.
Al? What?
Why?
Sorry.
You took my blood?
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
Well, you're gonna do great.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Ket corpse. For autopsy.
Oh, a dead one.
A live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Ket?
Harry didn't tell you? I'm a specialist in alien anatomy.
Research and stuff.
My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
I want to answer all these. These are all good answers. Interesting thesis.
That's a very specific topic.
I grew up on Omega, lots of Krogan mercenaries. The best habitat outside Tuchunka. But we were discussing the Ket. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan...
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats her vegetables.
You're awfully quick, I have to say. See if she has anything else to say before she dashes away like freaking the Flash here.
Ryder?
Right. Memory fragments, yes. Can you uncover more of them? I'm thinking no, we have to do it the prescribed way.
I need to talk to you about something private.
Of course. That's what I'm here for.
When Dad died, he blocked off parts of Sam's memory. Things he didn't want me to see.
Or he thought you weren't ready for.
Maybe. I found this trigger. It unlocked a memory fragment of Dad on the Citadel. From when the Alliance rejected his ideas about AI, and he found out Mom's illness was terminal.
Why do you think your father chose this specific memory?
Maybe it was a turning point.
It was where his journey to Andromeda really began.
Those events started your family down a new path.
Yeah. Thanks, Lexi. Feels good to talk about this.
Sorry, guys. Just messing with my... my headset. And I noticed that, you know, my voice is still weird. I mean, this is only recorded a few hours after last episode. So I don't know why it's really like that at this point. I haven't been talking that much. Working with it. Friendship with Harry.
How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis. We met at a medical convention on the Citadel.
How long ago was that?
He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments. His name card was crooked, but he was so damn confident, I knew we'd be friends.
Awkward and confident. How did you join the Hyperion?
So how did an Asari doctor end up on the human Ark?
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember? That includes humans. Also, Harry insisted. Maybe he always intended to switch jobs.
Well, I'll see you around.
I'll let you get back to it. I'll be here if you need me.
Besides, didn't Harry say he was retiring? We had a discussion about that. Got me. So, with the Sam note, he didn't have much to say to begin with, but I guess I'll try.
Storage if you need me.
In storage. This thing's pretty cool.
Maybe they could use you on comms.
So you get to be with the Pathfinder and I have to watch your radio?
The radio or help Kesh with cleanup?
Alright, so... Veteran, Liam.
Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me.
Who's this?
Ryder, this is Sid, my sister. Sid, Ryder.
Okay, so I'm glad I'm walking around and now I can actually talk to these people. I guess I should have just head right to the bridge first and then walked around because most of the people didn't have anything to say. And now they do, so I'm just walking around the ship again. Younger sister? Why? She sounds younger. Am I interrupting?
Hope I'm not interrupting something important. Not at all. We were just finishing up.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
Oh, why'd you cut her off like that?
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
Sorry guys, throat noise. I'd love an explanation.
Now's as good a time as any.
I know that I can be of use here. I know everyone on the crew. Even the actuators Gil prefers for the ship. Better, I know how to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best. We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
Hehe. She is intense, and I do like it. Yeah, I'm gonna say that.
Wow, that's some laser focus.
Yeah? Was it too much? Some people get intimidated.
I'm not just some people. I really like the intensity.
That's good. It's nice to feel appreciated.
Am I flirting with her?
I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know. We'll chat later?
Kinda looked like I was flirting with her. I just really approve of her personality. We can chat now. I didn't really mean to flirt with her, if that's what happened. I actually got right up and close with her and, you know, was like, you're freaking awesome.
Hey, Ryder.
You seem to know your way around the Tempest.
You're pretty familiar with the ship.
I made sure the technicians had what they needed to keep the Tempest ready and waiting. Leadership wanted to strip her for parts, but I kept saying, a Pathfinder's gonna show up. I like being right.
How'd you join the initiative?
How did she hear of the Andromeda initiative?
Short answer, Kesh. She was looking for some experimental ship mods, and I knew how to track them down. I thought it was a one-time deal, but she came back. Once, twice. Eventually, I figured out something was going on. Something big, with creds behind it. I asked and she told me about the initiative. New galaxy, new home. Couldn't pass that up.
Yeah, you saw the uprising?
You were on the Nexus when the revolt happened?
When you promise people golden worlds and all they get are wastelands and a death cloud, they riot. Some wanted to go home, some demanded answers, and a couple just wanted to stir shit up.
And you?
Some days I wondered if the exiles had a point. Maybe we were conned into coming here. But why would the initiative go to all this trouble just to screw us over? Thing about conning people, you always know something they don't. And that's why the con works. And if I'm going to pick a side, I'm picking the liars.
I'm only laughing because her description of the the reactions of people as what they were promised towards what they got reminds me a lot of the people who, you know, bought this game, or a lot of them didn't buy this game, the reactions to the game. Basically, not physical rioting, at least as far as I know, but death threats, and yeah, there's been a lot of backlash. Like I said, Mass Effect has, you know, a lot to live up to, and when it doesn't live up to, people freak out. I do think this is an awesome game. Still trying to figure out if it's an awesome Mass Effect game. So you mentioned back channels.
You talked about your back channels. What did you mean?
We brought a lot from home. Some of it marked initiative, some of it in personal caches. Most things you want, someone's got. You just have to figure out who, and what they're willing to take in exchange.
It seems predatory.
That just sounds like you're taking advantage of people.
Is it? I get people what they want, and they do want, or they wouldn't pay.
Well, I'll let you go.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Yep, most probably right here. Is this the furniture he was posting about?
I'll find it. Help me with something?
Bulletin board?
I know,
couch?
Not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclock Omni blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
It diffuses the charge from an overclocked Omni blade. Did that sentence make sense?
Right. What?
Never mind. BS for the requisition. So, finally time for that beer? And after 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your alliance days much?
What was Hustle?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy urban search terrain one? Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit. HUST-1, but... Hustle looks much better on the patch.
This looks like a lot
all
of beer.
Civilians, retired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded. Tastes better just thinking about those days.
Do I miss all that? Sure, I miss all that.
I wanted exploration, to chase the cutting edge of Prothean research. I thought I'd found my calling. Seems like a long time ago.
600 years, give or take. So, Pathfinder, why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
Why not?
That blunt.
Flirty? Maybe? Could be just friendly. Kinda curious to see if this leads towards a romantic thing, not that I want that, so maybe I shouldn't choose it. I need to leave that life. Sure, I need to leave that life. I have no idea why I need to leave that life, but yeah, let's go with it.
I was on a good path in the Alliance, then everything fell apart. There wasn't much left for me.
Andromeda was
so far away, I figured if you're going to start over, start way over.
Gotcha. Clean slate. Classic.
Back at you, Costa. Why do you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story. But it's bullshit.
Sure.
I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning. Still do. I have to. We're in it.
Hmm. We could change direction, how? I found some, find some choices I want to choose because I don't know what the hell. We could change direction. Do what? You know, typically I wouldn't say this, but I just want to know what this is, changing direction.
We can't go back, but we're not trapped by decisions a galaxy behind us.
I don't feel trapped. We came from a good place for good reasons. We keep that in mind or steer us right, just like back in Crisis Response. Remember the essentials. A new start guided by the Pathfinder. And team. I'll bust my tail to make that a good story.
I'm drinking along with them, but I'm drinking hot cocoa. Alright, so we weren't in here before, or were we? I think this was just empty, yeah. So now there's a person in it named Liam. We can talk to again. Yeah, we were here before. I was wondering why this image was static and didn't change. There's the same image in another area, but it keeps changing to different images.
Pathfinder?
Well, tell me about yourself.
Barely covered how you joined. Tell me something about yourself.
All right. I was a bad student, piss poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it all been done. I wasn't looking to start over. I wanted to start big.
Hmm. Any family?
Tell me about your family.
I miss the hell out of them. Some nights you just cry, right? That's the thing everyone does. Mom,
maybe.
Joelle, Dad, Calvin. Both lawyers. Met on the Citadel, settled on Earth. No brothers or sisters. That might have been too much to leave. It was traditional. How about you?
Yeah, I guess we were non-traditional, right? We weren't really close with our father, and if anything was mentioned of her mother, I don't even remember. Oh, that's right, her mother died of, she died. Terminal illness. Who defines traditional? Yeah, I'll say that.
Traditional is a weird term for family, like normal. Who's that describe?
I suppose you're right. I sure didn't keep the tradition. I said goodbye to my mom and dad, and got on the ship to Andromeda.
Hmm. What about your career history?
You were a cop, then Crisis Response? Couldn't have been long in either.
Didn't have the patience for law, so I figured enforcement. Dad knew it didn't fit before I did. But it got me into hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
Hmm. Sounds satisfying.
You found your place. Not everyone gets that.
I knew it. Glad for it every day. And that led me here.
Okay, goodbye.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
You know it. You should be saying you know it, not I know it. Alright, so I think we've talked to everyone on this floor. Sooner or later, guys, I'll know where everyone is by heart. Lexi, Sam. Hate to run all the way, but this is technically a crew update, right? You guys have watched my Mass Effect trilogy know that, you know, I do crew updates. This is Glass, okay? So this is essentially our first crew update. So if Sam has anything new to say, like everyone else does, so we should do that. Oh, we can get a look at the Nexus. Cool. It was very similar to the Citadel, just less wings or whatever you call it. We talked to Sam in here, I believe, right? Yeah.
Hello, Sarah. It is interesting to be renewed.
Renewed?
How do you mean?
Since my creation, I have been Alec Ryder's Sam. Now, I am your Sam.
Sam,
I
am.
I am still myself, but now the input and experiences I have are completely new. I will develop in a new direction. The term reincarnation seems appropriate.
So like with Doctor Who, regeneration. You're the same, but your workings are different. Dad and I, are that different? I think we are that different.
Being linked to me is a totally new experience?
You and Alec are unique individuals.
Yeah, we're all unique.
I can now see the variations that define you. I look forward to our continued partnership.
Okay. Yes, definitely. Okay, I'm glad I came back here to talk to him. Memory triggers. Any more memory triggers?
Sam, any more information on the memory trigger we found?
The memory blocks are still in place. If you continue searching for more triggers, they may unlock.
I gotta find those things. Your location.
Are you still on the Hyperion?
Yes. This terminal provides a direct link to my servers in SAM node on the Ark. I can maintain a presence on the Tempest via quantum entanglement communication.
I know what this means, but just for a review and to see what Sam says, and for any of you guys out there who might not know what the quantum entanglement is, yeah, it's a basically some kind of FTL, like audio. Yeah, let me remind myself.
Let's say, hypothetically, I was out sick the day they taught quantum embezzlement? Communism.
Communism?
With entangled subatomic particles, it's possible to conduct secure and instantaneous communication across great distances. It ensures I remain in touch with you and the Pathfinder team at all times.
Okay. So maybe not necessarily FTL, but yeah. Quick communication. You don't have to wait for a relay to go, you know, from, I don't know. On the other side of the cluster could otherwise take years, at least. Scott and I. Oh yeah, that's her brother. Still don't know what's going on with him. He still hasn't woken up.
What was Dad's take on Scott and I?
He believed your family trials brought you closer together, and hoped that would endure. It appears that hope was well-founded.
Okay. Humor? Do you have a stand-up routine, Sam?
So if we're going to work together, you might notice I like to joke around sometimes, lighten things up. How's your sense of humor, Sam?
Alec Ryder encouraged me to develop this skill.
Humor's not a skill, it's... Okay, try telling me a joke.
Here we go.
A neutron enters a bar and asks, "How much is a drink?" The bartender replies, "For you, no charge."
I can see why Dad told you to keep working on your humor.
Multiple perspectives.
Is it confusing to be in multiple places talking to different people?
Yeah, true.
My awareness can be partitioned, so I can give you the same attention as, say, a SAM node technician. In the field, you are my primary focus, and all other requests are queued. In the vernacular, you have my undivided attention.
Yes, but if you're partitioned, then you are divided.
Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
Can't believe a half hour has already passed. I want to finish the update, though. Let's see. The crew update. So, deck 3 complete. Deck 2 is Gil. Cora. Oh, she wanted to talk to us. We already talked to Suvi and... and Callow. And I have to go to the meeting room. So I need to go up. And I always, like, go to click on exit to desktop, and it's not what I want to do. So I believe there's a ladder somewhere around here. Or I can take that lift. I see the lift, so let's go that way.
Pathfinder, making the rounds.
S.A.M.
Slumming it, huh? Want to see how the riffraff are making out?
Meh. Someone has to.
Hey, it's a dirty job. Are you the riffraff spokesman?
King, actually. You might want to bow. Otherwise, things might start falling off the Tempest at the most inopportune times.
I'll take my chances.
I'm gonna bow.
Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the initiative.
Okay, her outfit, I just realized, these are the old colors. It must have been hard.
Seems like life back there was pretty bleak.
Not gonna lie, it sucked. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and, oops, I just made a decision there's no turning back from. I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
Is that a flirty thing? You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up. Well, not me specifically.
You mean how jazzed you were that a Pathfinder showed up?
Tomato, potato. You just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
So far, I don't like this guy very much. He's kind of... I don't know, a pompous ass kind of person.
Long time no chat. What's up?
What do you think of the Tempest?
I hear we have you to thank for getting the Tempest space ready so quickly.
Or that.
Vetra brings her impossible feats to me. I was itching to get this particular call. Capital R, ready. Don't tell her, but the truth is, I fudge reports to come in early, then bust ass in secret to make up for it. Expands
what?
The guild legend. Plus, I convey calm and assurance, and the whole team relaxes, which helps them do their jobs better.
Speaking of our crew...
Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Veteran Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. As far as your Hyperion peeps go, Doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, she's a bit by the book for me.
Well, I think we need that.
By the book keeps us alive.
Hey, variety's the spice of life, right? Different strokes makes for healthy debate.
What about Kello?
He's a pilot.
Which means...
He flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that, then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
Okay. This guy's kind of a jerk, isn't he? Do you have any friends, sir?
What's your social circle like?
Oh, I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people. But I don't let too many in. My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me.
Who's that?
The more you and I get to know each other, the more you'll probably hear about her.
Okay. Just say I'm waiting on bated breath for that. Not really. The Nexus.
How tough has it been on the Nexus all these months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
No.
Can't say I have.
Well, let me tell you, it's tough. Wondering if you're gonna die from a critical malfunction, or maybe starvation. Imagining which would be worse. But hey, you could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Mm. Maybe even participate in a revolt.
What was your take on that?
I didn't place any bets, if that's what you're asking. Truth is, I don't think anyone made out particularly well. Whatever side you're on, you die a little when your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
Oh, that's a human condition for you. and the Turian condition, and the Krogan condition, and the Asari condition. Yeah. The space cow thing was, by the way, a nod to Mass Effect 1, the little space shifty cows. I'm pretty sure it is.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
Okie doke. So I'm here, and we need one to be... We talked to him. Yeah, I've been putting up some long episodes, but I kind of... Alright, we're done with this whole... Oh, Quora. We do need to talk to Quora, and she specifically said that she wanted to talk to us, so... And then I need to visit the VidCom room, or whatever that's called. Conference room. Video room. That goes down. I don't want to go down. What's down again? We're on... this is down. Okay, and then we need to go up at some point. So she's where? She's in the bio lab, okay. All these people, they weren't there when we initially looked around. Now they're there.
Nice place you found. Clean air, plants, helps me think. Something on your mind? Maybe.
Whoa.
What the hell was that? I know that look. It's just my biotics reacting to... all this. I don't normally lose it like that. A Huntress should have better control. Huntress?
Yes.
Another term for an Asari commando. Huntress. I was one before the initiative.
Okay.
Some things stick though. Like losing the old man.
We've been through this. You're an Asari commando. Well, I guess she's going to give us more background, but this is a silly question to ask because you've been through this.
How does a human soldier get to serve with Asari?
On the Nexus.
Prove your biotics can rip an APC apart, and people get nervous. Funny that. The Alliance found me a cross-species military initiative in a hurry. Sent me to Thessia to serve with the Huntress unit. One of the few places where my powers were welcomed. Your father made another one.
Hmm. Did you know my father well?
You were his second in command. Were you friends, too? He was more a mentor than a friend. Prickly old bastard. But I respected that. People treat geniuses like they're made of cut glass. I didn't care how smart he was. I think he liked someone not caring.
Hmm. Why would she say this? I'm not sure what that the tone of this is. I'm still here, we can talk. We were already talking. We've all lost something. I'm picking that because I don't know what that means.
There's a lot of loss going around. Dad, the Golden Worlds. A friend and mentor who trained you to be a Pathfinder.
Mm-hmm.
I prepped for years as your father's second. Then he chooses you?
Uh-oh.
An untrained Pathfinder and all this mess to fix? The hell was he thinking?
Competition?
Is this going to be a problem, Cora? I don't want a rival. Just answers. It's done. Best I can do now is be your second. Keep your father's mission alive. Then maybe we'll all get what we came out here for.
What's with the lighting getting lighter and darker? I noticed that before. And her hair is a lot better done. Than, what's her name? Suvi's? God, it looked horrible. It looked like someone just scribbled on the screen. From what I've heard, she's straight, but what did you come for? We'll be good together, baby.
You, me, side by side? I like the sound of that. A commando friend said something like that once. I explained I wasn't into women, however admirable they might be.
Damn you!
So I said I'd still take a bullet for her. We were a team. Look, there's still the mission.
A lot of dreams to fulfill.
What did you come for?
So what brought you out to Andromeda?
Biotics like this. Thinking like an Asari huntress. I never had a place. Best I could be was a useful freak. The initiative was meant to be different. Will be different if this mission succeeds. So I'm seeing it through. It's quiet in here. I can keep the plants watered while I work. First job, see if there's any news on the Asari Ark. If they made it, we could use some Asari expertise.
True.
If you want to talk, I'll be here.
Okay. What? Okay, that's weird. Because I guess I'm up against this. Let me get away from that then. Alright, she's got more options, I'm sure.
Ryder?
Disappointing, though. Tell me about Asari Commandos.
What did you do while you were part of the Asari military?
4 years in a commando unit called Talane's Daughters. Part of the Council's cross-species military integration initiative. Your time defending Silva's expedition was probably more important. But we did good work. Peacekeeping is a full-time job, even in Asari space.
True. Tell me about your unit.
What was your commando unit like?
Janae and I were the youngsters. Tethys was our old lady sniper. Kalia patched us up, and Valenza prayed between firefights. Our CO, Nasira, led us all over the Athena Nebula and beyond. A huntress's work is never done.
Isn't Asari space peaceful? I know, not entirely.
Who'd pick a fight with the most powerful species in the galaxy?
Themselves, usually. Terrorists, cults, rogue Ardot Yakshi.
Supposed to be only two.
People demanding a withdrawal from the Citadel. The Asari were spacefaring when our Roman Empire was new. Didn't fix all their problems. Sometimes you need commandos for that.
Yeah, that was the whole, the Ardot Yakshi thing still bothers me, guys. Really, there was like three total that Samara knew of, which were all her daughters. And then, all of a sudden, Mass Effect 3 comes along, and we have a whole monastery full of them. Which, it's not like Samara shows up at the monastery. There's no explanation like, well, I thought the only ones were my daughters, and here's this whole monastery. I wasn't aware of this place. No, it was complete, you know, retcon. And, of course, there's even more that you meet throughout the game turn into banshees, so yeah, three out of Yakshay turn into, like, at least 3 dozen. Did you have anyone special?
Did you come out here with anyone? Maybe someone you served with?
I had my fun on shore leave. Nothing serious, though. Asari huntresses figure things out, but I was there for soldiering, not romance.
How do they figure it out?
Does that mean fraternization is okay for Asari commandos?
It'll happen, but usually only for one deployment. Asari don't usually stay with each other long term.
What?
After your 500th birthday, you learn some self-control.
Well, true, they usually pair off with other races, as opposed to themselves, which is seen in a negative light by many. So tell me about your military career.
You were in the Alliance before you became a huntress, right? What made you join up?
My biotics. I was still living on my parents' cargo freighter when they manifested. Untrained biotic power on a starship means accidents.
Yeah, I was thinking.
But we couldn't afford a tutor. The Alliance had implants, the training, everything. Old history now. Your turn. Remind me why you came to Andromeda.
The Prothean digs woke us up to how much we don't know, and to what humanity's next leap might be. Then Dad's career collapsed. His AI research made him too toxic.
I heard. Must have changed everything for your family.
Uh, We needed a fresh start.
We needed to start over somewhere new. Together. Or as together as we could. So, Andromeda.
None of you writers ever think small, do you?
Nope. And do you have any war stories?
After 4 years with Asari Commandos, he must have some great war stories.
Nasira assassinated a Krogan warlord with a pack of playing cards once.
A pack of cards?
Wow.
Choking hazard, apparently.
Wow.
That's it? If I choose this, will she tell another story?
Any more Commando war stories?
Always liked Janae. She was only 200, and with me around, she wasn't the kid anymore. She was a biotic prodigy. I once saw her yank an AA gun right off its housing. Crushed a gang of slavers with it.
Cool.
Ouch.
They didn't feel it for long.
Guess
not. Janae was a good friend. Maybe she still is back there. Won't be a kid now, though.
How many times can we pull the string?
Any more Commando war stories?
Not just now. I'll try to remember a good one.
Now, this repeats. How about, like, does she say the same thing, like, for example, this?
Did you come out here with anyone? Maybe someone you served with?
I had my fun on shore leave. Asari huntresses figure things out, but I was there for soldiering, not romance.
I was just wondering.
Careful. One day I might be this nosy about your personal life.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
Right, so some conversation options, the responses repeat, others not. Of course, it's hard to tell. If they do repeat, they should keep that section white instead of, you know, the gray that indicates you already chose it. I guess, or maybe some separate color in between would be cool. Little things like that are cool. I think that's it. Talk to Gil, talk to Cora, and these, of course, we talked to these two last episode at the end, and let's go. To deck one. Gil. Wait. Is this deck one? I think it is. This is deck one. Okay, so we've already been here. Meeting room, VidCon. Guess we can't... Wait. Oh, I can use this here. No calls available at this time. Okay. I didn't see that before when I was up here. Okay. Another long episode.
Where's my data pad? Oh, how'd you get under there?
Suvi, were you talking to your notebook?
Oh, I was, wasn't I? I do that sometimes.
Haha. She's cool. Alright, so yeah, another long-ass episode. I hope you guys don't mind these episodes being this long. The rest are probably going to be shorter. I just want to do a crew update all in one episode. And if I split this in half, we're going to have 25-minute episodes, and that's kind of small, I feel. I try to, you know, make them for 30 or over. But there's nothing left to do, and this is a good logical place to stop off. So next time... Oh, wow. You can actually see even better like that than from our quarters. Next time, we're going to head back to the Nexus, if we can. And we have a mission or two to wrap up, or at least further along there. So, thanks so much for watching. See you in the next one, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.